Brussels, 1928. The surrealist Magritte paints a highly curious work. Brussels, 2008. This time, it's the politician's turn. It's an ambitious project to pump up to 120 billion cubic meters of Caspian gas across six countries to Europe. The inspiration? To meet Europe's future energy demands and to gain energy independence from Russia. Currently, Russia provides nearly 30% of the EU's natural gas. Given Russia's previous behavior, Europe has good reason to worry. So, to diversify energy supplies, getting gas from Azerbaijan instead makes sense. Or does it? Azerbaijan has never had a free and fair election. Political arrests, torture, and disappearances are common. Recently, the regime was accused of bribing EU politicians to soften them up for the pipeline deal. A deal that's very interesting to Turkey, currently in a state of emergency and also becoming extremely authoritarian. If the EU is so critical of Russia, should it really be enriching these regimes? The pipeline is already causing suffering on the ground. In Italy, there will be impacts on tourism, water quality, and people's livelihoods. In Albania and Greece, the pipeline crosses farmers' land with little compensation. And then there's the wider problem of our changing climate. The Paris Agreement states we need to aim for a low carbon economy. But building massive new gas infrastructure will lock us into this damaging fossil fuel for decades to come. Each dollar invested will result in damage of up to $13 from global climate change. If we end up using it, the dropping price of renewables is casting Europe's future demand for gas into doubt. When renewables come fully online, this pipeline will end up as a huge, useless source of debt for European citizens. And there's another can of worms. The gas emerging from the Azerbaijani gas fields has been much less than promised, certainly not enough to justify the pipeline's cost. So more gas will be needed to fill the pipeline. Guess where from? That's right. Since its gas may end up coming through the pipeline anyway, Russia won't be too troubled by this project. In fact, Russia may well find it amusing that Europe has given billions to countries with terrible human rights records, undermined its own values and principles, spent its budget on a white elephant, and locked us into fossil fuels, all whilst undermining the renewable energy revolution. The real threat to Russia's oligarchy. This pipeline, however the EU paints it, is the true treachery of images.